decades.
Tonight, he's speaking out about the local program that set him free. News 5's Laura Borchers is live with what he's saying. Laura?
Yet tonight we talked with the man exonerated after two decades behind bars. And tonight he was visiting this campus right here to say thank you to the law school students that helped to clear his name.
I was kidnapped by the state of Ohio 20 years ago for something I did not do. And the Ohio Innocence Project out of UC got me out.
In 1991, a jury convicted Dean Gillispie of rape for kidnapping three women from the Dayton Mall.
I knew it was 16 to 50, and I had 20 in when I finally got out. So it was a lot longer haul than I ever dreamed it would be.
After serving 16 years, a parole board may have released him if he'd admitted to the crimes, but he refused to confess to something he didn't do. This group, the University of Cincinnati's Innocence Project, heard his cry.
10 years of digging, scratching, clawing, fighting bad people.
Now these UC students and their professor continue fighting for others like Gillispie.
Each fellow at the Innocence Project usually handles between 25 and 30 cases throughout their year on the project.
He's one of their few victories.
We do have people who write in and say that they're innocent, and then when we start to investigate the case, we find that they have had some kind of involvement, and at that point, we terminate our relationship.
Megan Collard looks for injustices in cases. In Gillispie's, he had an alibi. There was no physical evidence. He didn't fit the victim's descriptions and had even been cleared by original detectives. But 2 years after the crimes, victims picked him out of a photo lineup where his photo was a different size and the only one with a different background color. After 20 years, last month, a judge ruled Gillispie never saw due process. Now at 46, he starts to make up for stolen decades.
The Ohio Innocence Project is the greatest asset Ohio has. There's nothing better.
He may be a free man, but the state is still tracking every step he takes. He's forced to wear a tracking device on his ankle, and he also has to register as a sex offender. That all has to happen until the prosecutor has completed all appeals. Reporting live at the University of Cincinnati, I'm Laura Borchers.